IMC and the National Academy of Science. So I have to start on the change here.
Well, we are in Emilia-Romagna region in Italy. It is in the north of Italy. It is the land where we produce Parmesan, Parmesan cheese, Ferrari cars. But nevertheless, we are facing, as in the rest of Italy, a severe economic crisis. And the government is implementing a spending review to reduce the public expenditure. This is the regional declination of the national health system. So this is our regional health system. In Italy, the region and the nation, the government, guarantees all citizens with universal and equal access to the services. And it ensures health care by means of local health trusts, university hospitals, and universities and hospitals.
Now we see some demographics we are facing, and it's quite a new phenomenon for Italy, not like in the USA. We are facing a strong migration. Mainly from Morocco, Albania, People's Republic of China, India, Romania. And these new citizens count for the 13% of the total population. And the elderly, the over 65s, count for the 22.3%. And as we will see in a minute, the literacy scale of adult population in Italy are very, very low. I made a mistake. We, as the updates of the study of the 2008 showed, Italy is in the last places concerning health literacy skills. In Italy, one of the reasons may be that in Italy, half of the adult population leaves school only with a middle school leaving certificate. And once you leave school in Italy, it's very difficult to go back to school again. It's very difficult, it's very hard, and it's very, very difficult for adult population. We don't have many schools for adults who left school when they were young. We understood the importance of health literacy. Actually, when we met Professor Roth, we met her in 2007 in the US, and then we invited her to Italy, and we knew each other, and then we asked her to come to work with us, and she came, she accepted our invitation, so she came for a full week work. A full work week in November 2011, then again in January-February 2012. What did we do? In 2008, the company where I worked, in the public company where I worked, we organized a group on health literacy techniques. And then in 2011, we asked the region, we proposed to the region to form a regional group focused on health literacy and defining which activities were needed. You know, every local company and every hospital needs to have to answer to the region. The regional group has 11 members. They are the 11 communication directors of the local health companies and hospital companies. And then are members of the group also the training manager and the communication manager of the regional health system. The main objective of this group concerns the improvement of written and oral communication skills. To achieve these objectives, we use the cooperation of Professor Ibarat, who comes with me. This training course included 74 participants, which means 4 people from each local health trust. We had 2 groups, one composed of top
communicator and one operator of front office. And on each day, space was dedicated to group work and analysis. And it was very, very challenging, very nice path. What did we do with the doctors and nurses? With them, with we special attention was paid to the imbalance between the expectation of the system and the skills of the patients, and possible actions and methods were also proposed for improving the patient interaction, including feedback. For the communicator, special attention was paid to the clarity of the language using the information material. And also in this case, techniques were analyzed for reviewing, for creating, reviewing, and assessing the information materials. Then between the two editions of the training courses, Rimarut gave us homework, which we did. The clinician had mainly to try pitch back in the words, and they did. And the communicators had to review materials and to find the barriers of the environment in their everyday activity. Maybe it's the same in the States. If we have a training course, then we have evaluation and learning the questionnaire. From this questionnaire, it emerged that even after a few days, of course, it was possible to achieve tangible results. And the participants remarked the need for a broader training. Some of them said this training should be mandatory for all the workers of the hospitals, because they understood the importance of health literacy. And they also stressed the importance of the commitment of the regional level. After the training course, the 2 weeks training course, it was decided to implement two parallel paths on each local trust. One is dedicated to the health professional-patient relationship, and the other to assess the information materials. And both paths are going to be carried out in three sectors, in three oncologic sectors, breast, prostate, and colorectal cancer. What are we going with the path which concerns doctor and patient relationship? The dissemination of health literacy skills will be done by nurses and doctors, two parts of course held by Professor Wood, and they will train other colleagues in a peer training method. So we will have repeated edition because the aim is to train all the workers, the health workers working in this three oncological sector. It would be a long work because there are many. Concerning the communication, this path in each health trust, the information materials available for each oncologic sector will be analyzed first at the local level with the patients, association, relatives, and then in a second time at the regional level, in order to achieve benchmarking and to create a regional template which could be customized by the region. Finally, maybe we will not be able to respect this deadline of the Toronto. By the end of 11-12, each local health trust should hold a two-day training course for clinicians working in the oncological field, as I said before, using the field training method. And also the materials assessment and review should be ended by the end of 2011. I don't know if we will be able to, but we're trying. And the regional health assessment working to become an arbitrator organization and to achieve the objective associated with the development of arbitrator's attributes amongst the main 2011-2012 goals for Arbitrast directors. You know, each year the regional level assigns objectives that the directors must achieve. So this is what the development of arbitrator skills is given by the regional assessment to our directors. That's it. Thank you for your attention.